What's up, you guys? It's Lorna Marie. Today I am bringing you what's inside my EDC bag, which stands for Everyday Carry. Most of these videos are for men, but I thought I would give my interpretation because I love like the whole concept of prepping, being prepared. I'm a Virgo. You guys know I love organizing containers, all that stuff. This pertains to me. So when I started seeing this whole world of EDC, I went down the rabbit hole. I'm watching like men that are green berets and like military people and all these things, and I'm like, yes, give it to me. Show me all the things that you keep inside of these bags and all the things that I need to have on me to be prepared if there's an emergency or something happens. That's what I wanted. So all the purse bags you guys have seen in the past have not had my EDC. I would say it has more like makeup and, you know, like Tide sticks and stuff like that, emergencies, like personal emergencies, not like family emergencies, emergencies where you need to save your life and stuff like that. So I'm starting to change what I carry inside of my purse. So if you guys want to see an entire what's inside of my purse video, I will be doing that for you guys as well. But today is just my EDC bag that I keep inside of my purse. If I switch purses or anything like that, I'm switching that bag as well. So if you guys feel like depositing some positive energies, give your girl a thumbs up. I'd so appreciate it. If you haven't done so, definitely subscribe and hit that little bell if you like videos like this so you are notified every time. I will list and link everything I can for you guys down below. Most of everything is from Amazon. So this is going to be an Amazon EDC video because it is all from there, baby. So it'll be so easy for you guys to order and get all that stuff together. Now, question of the day is, do you guys carry an EDC? Have you ever heard of it? Is it something that you want to carry in the future after this video? Let me know in the comments below. So without further ado, if you guys want to see what's inside my EDC bag, what I like to keep inside for emergencies, then just keep watching. All right, you guys, let's get into my EDC bag. I am so pumped to show you guys this. This is a very important video for me because I literally carry this with me everywhere I go. I have been studying EDC bags that men carry and I wanted to customize it for me. Now, this is not the only bag that I carry. I wanted to put these over here. I also carry these bags over here. Especially the day and age we're in, it is so important to have essentials on you. Also, I have another bag. This is in my day bag. So like when I carry a backpack, we go hiking, or I just, you know, want to bring more essentials with me, I have this huge big old thing that I put in my backpack. So anyways, if you're interested in any of those, let me know. I can always do those videos in the future for you. I carry this backpack purse and I stick all of these items in it. I just personally like having a lot of essentials on me, especially nowadays, the day and age we're in. So if you feel like I'm missing something, it's probably in one of these bags. I'm not gonna show you what's in those today, just my EDC bag. This is basically all of my emergency essentials. This is not gonna be any food, hygiene, medicine. Today we're focusing on my EDC bag and all of the contents inside of here. So let's open it up. And you guys know that I get everything from Amazon, always, most things. All the men's ones that I saw, they were black and I don't know, they just really look like they were for men. And I was gonna get one of them just cause I love the organization until I found this one. I wanted something compact. I had ordered something originally, but it was like double this size. So let me show you like compared to gum, okay? So it's not that huge. It may look really thick cause I've like, it's jam packed, you guys. There's so much stuff inside of here. Which I'm glad, I wanna keep as much things inside of here as possible, but there's two zipper areas and they're both different. So we're gonna start off in the front area first. All right, so the first area flips open to this thing here, okay? So a few things move around, which is totally fine. I'm still not in my house or in my RV, so you guys said you still wanted to see the video, so here I am, making sure I get some content out there for you guys, but this is not my table, and if you hear a fan in the background, I apologize, but girl, it is hot. So I need to be able to work in peace and not be scorching hot. So anyways, this is the inside. And one thing that I love is it has these band straps to keep things inside. It's just nice. I like that it's light, it's not dark. Things don't get lost inside of it. This is just more my style. And I know a lot of you guys that watch me like this feminine touch as well. So let's get into what's inside. Okay, so the first thing I have a whistle and a flashlight. I attach this to the outside of my purse. I know it's kind of funky looking and, but you never know. I feel like I'm at a place now where it's like, yes, I want to be cute, but I also want to be safe and I want things to have a purpose and be functional. This is safety. Safety is number one over anything.
because your stuff's not going to be cute if you're not alive. So I like to have a flashlight for safety walking to the car. I also like to have a whistle on me. You never know, okay? So I have a few other safety items like this extra pepper spray right here. I have a cute container that goes around it. I don't know where it's at. This is the one to my car, but I just wanted to show you guys this anyways, that I do keep pepper spray on me for emergencies. You definitely want to make sure you learn how to use it before you use it. So next up, I have an extra contact lens case. This normally goes into like my hygiene section, but there wasn't enough room and it fits here perfectly, so that's perfectly fine. So next up, we have my bug repellent. I love this bug repellent. This works really good. It actually has DEET in it, and if you go hiking or you get sick out into the woods for whatever reason, it is very strong. It's not good for your skin, so definitely keep that in mind. All right, next up we have my Sharpie pen. And this is just so good for emergencies. If somebody gets bit by a snake or a spider, you can mark it. It writes on anything. It's just good to have a Sharpie. This has a fine point and also the thick point on either end. Next up, we have this tactical pen. I love this because it's pink. It has a leveler on here. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it also has a stylus. But the best part about this pen is it is a tactical pen, which means it can also be used as a weapon. So you kind of hold it like this and you stab somebody wherever you need to, which sounds very violent. But if you're in a situation and you need to pull this out and you feel uncomfortable somewhere, you gotta do what you gotta do. Next up, we have this pen here, which this is so cool because it has all different screws in it. Let me pull them out for you guys. The lid pops off here and then you kind of dump them out here. Now there's all different sizes. I don't know if you can see how little that gets, which is great. So there's all different sizes in here and you can also use it as a weapon. Next up is our tried and true Tide Stick. Always, always, always carry one of these on me. It's came in so handy. I can't even tell you guys, and they actually work miracles. I'm just like, does this work better than the actual detergent? I don't know if it's the friction motion that you use with a pen and what the pen's made out of, but I'm telling you, it works better than the detergent in my opinion. Next up, we have our little fire starter. I suggest you try it out first. I have another one that I've tried out. You want to learn how to use it. There's a learning curve. It's not easy. But yeah, watch a couple videos, learn how to use. I suggest learning to use everything that you have, but even if you don't know how to use it, I feel like it's better to have it than not. You could be with someone that does know how to use it. But yeah, always try to learn your equipment. That's so important. Okay, so next up is this very weird device, which it looks like a pen, but it's not. So this actually saves somebody's keys. Oh, look. So it opens up, okay, very long, like, and then it is magnetic. So you can pick things up. Somebody actually saved their keys in the comments when I was looking at it on Amazon. That's what honestly sold me on it. I got this from my husband. He's like, this is so cool. So anyways, I love that it's just super compact and it opens up to really long. I'm sure there's so many things you could do with this, but people have used this and said that it really comes in handy. Next up, we have a very, very unique item. So this is a elevator tool, which this is so weird. And no, I have not tried it personally, but I've watched lots of videos on it. And this is actually if you ever were to get stuck in an elevator. Now I'm somewhere where there's a lot of earthquakes and things can go wrong and power goes down and all that weird stuff. So I thought it would be a good idea to have it. Why not? It's very small and compact. And I just like having it. And when people see this, they're like, what is that? I got one for my kids too. They're like, this is so cool. So anyways, look it up yourself on Amazon and watch some videos about it. But this is an elevator key. Okay, next up, we have a little pair of scissors. I have some other tools that have scissors, but I just like having extra scissors everywhere. I feel like what I see is redundancy is key when you're doing and you're building an EDC bag. You wanna have multiple ways to start fires, multiple ways to cut things, multiple ways to do everything. All right, so next up in here, I'm gonna dig this guy out. A thing for the car. I just like having an extra one on me. It's nice to keep in here for emergencies. I do have one in my car, but if I'm in someone else's car that doesn't have one, I think this is important. Next up, we have this gorgeous lighter. You guys, is this not the prettiest lighter you've ever seen? Like, look how beautiful this is. so freaking pretty. It's like little stones. It feels like stones too. It's not too heavy, but it just wraps around a regular ugly Bic lighter, so then you can bling it out and make it super cute. So this is obviously self-explanatory why you want to start a fire. To keep warm if you just get, who knows, okay? Like there's so many reasons why. That's actually one of the most important things to have with you inside of your kit. How to start a fire, how to clean water, how to keep warm. Like there's basic things that you want to keep in your EDC bag. All right, next up we have a measuring tape. I just personally like having this on me. I mean, I measure furniture, measure things for fixing up things. I just love having this on me, and I found a really cute one from Amazon, obviously. So we have a cute little pair of tweezers. I just like having tweezers on me. Next up is this spoon fork situation. I cannot tell you how many times I've actually used this. People don't give you forks for your salad. It's really irritating. I've definitely used the fork more, but I've used the spoon. I love having this on me. You just wash it and you're good to go. Next up, I carry three little zip ties in here. You never know if you need to perform a citizen's arrest. I'm just kidding. Or, I mean, who knows what, you could be zip tying anything, but I think it's just great for emergencies to have in here. Then I have a notebook if you need to write things down or if somebody, you know, gets that bug bite and you need to do timing for whatever. You need to time something, whatever it is, you have a notebook in here. Just, it's really, really skinny and flat. And then I just hold a little bit of money in here just in case for emergencies. Okay, so that is it for this front section here. And now we're gonna move on to the middle section. Okay, so I zipped this part up. And when you open this part, this kind of looks a little crazy because there's a lot in here. And it just kind of is wedged in here. It's like, it's everything is supposed to stand up like this. As you can see, it's just a pocket where you can stuff things down into. So I pretty much look at it from this view here and I can grab whatever I need. Let's go through things one by one. Okay, so the first thing I have here is, a little mini sewing kit. Love this guy, super handy. Next up we have, okay, this may seem weird, but this is powdered dish soap for the dishwasher. I like having this on me. It just takes a couple little grains to wash like my spoon or whatever it is. And I just think it's good to have an emergency situation. If I need to wash whatever it is, my water bottle, I just like having this on me. This may be a weird item for people to have, but like having that. So then in this side right here, I just have two pink garbage bags and they're pretty big size. And then I have just some Ziploc bags. Next up inside of here, pull it out into the light. I have this little pill container. It looks like a pill, it's not four pills. I guess you could put pills in there if you wanted to. But this came with straws. I will link these down below for you guys. I just love this little container. It's so freaking handy. Let me take everything out of here so you can see what's in here. There we have it. Inside of here, I have waterproof matches, Q-tips, I have safety pins, bobby pins, hair ties, earplugs, and crazy glue. And it all fit in here, which is absolutely amazing. I just think it's so important to have these things on you. Next up, I'm gonna bring two items out at the same time because I feel like they go together. I have a knife sharpener and I have a knife. And I know it sounds really weird. Why would I carry around a knife sharpener if I already have a knife? But they say you're only as sharp as your knife. So I think that's what the saying is, correct me down below. But it's so important to have a sharp knife. It's like, why even have a knife on you? But I wanna have a knife sharper on me if I need to cut wood or something weird or whatever it is. I have both on me, so it's not necessary. I think a knife would be just fine, but I like to keep a knife sharpener on me. I also have people that I'm around that carry knives, and it's just like, I feel so good when I can just whip it out and be like, I got a knife sharpener. So anyways, I have this really cute pink one. Let me open it up so you can see it. It's really sharp because obviously I have a sharpener, but yeah, I love it. It's pink, it's so cute. And if anybody messes with me, I will whip it out and do what I need to do, you know? I've also used it to cut open boxes, all kinds of stuff. I used to carry a box opener in here, but I'm like, I don't need both. And it was taking up a lot of space, so I keep that at my house, and then I can just open boxes with this. All right, we are down to our last couple of items here. Next up, we have this pink box. It is actually a multi-tool. So it has all kinds of stuff. I'm gonna pop some of them open so you guys can see what's in here. But it's got a wrench and pliers and you name it, it's on here. All right, here's just an example of what's on here, but we have some pliers and a box, not a box cutter, but a, it's like a miniature saw. Then we got a bottle opener. I mean, there are so many other tools on here, even a screwdriver, all that stuff. So I've used everything in here pretty much, especially this. I use the pliers all the time. There's always things that I need it for. So last couple items. This is just a bracelet. The one thing I'm missing out of here, I need to put in here, is my little compass. I cannot find it anywhere. I have one of these that has a compass on here, and I usually keep that one in here, but I switched it out for this little light pink one, and I'm like, oh crap, I don't have a compass on here anymore. Anyways, paracord is great for emergency situations. You can tie things up, take this bracelet apart. I also have paracord in my emergency kit from Amazon that has like 7 different cords. You can start fire, you can do all kinds of stuff. This is just a basic one, which is fine for my purse. But yeah, I mean, if you're ever in a bind, you can use the paracord for whatever you need to. All right, the last thing are these water purification tablets. And I know that seems weird to carry, like just get water wherever you're at. But just keep in mind, I'm now using this bag for emergency situations, like worst case scenario. And I'm just feeling like the day and age we're in, I wanna have more of those items on me. So having water purification, I'm hiking all the time, I'm active, I'm busy. Even if you're not, I would suggest having one. So anyways, I like having these in here, like God forbid I just get dumped off in the wilderness or something weird happens, I got some water purifying tabs. If you guys are interested in seeing what's in my bag and what's inside of all of these little pouches and what's inside my day bag, let me know in the comments below what you guys want to see first.
All right, you guys, I hope you enjoyed what's inside my EDC bag. I absolutely loved putting this video together. You guys know me, organization, preparedness, all wrapped up into one little ball. I'm about that life. And so now this bag literally goes with me everywhere. I do not leave it at home. If I go hiking, whatever it is, this comes with me. This is my have-to, must-have items, and I absolutely love it. EDC videos are so fun and inspiring to me, so if you guys are organizers like I am, go down the rabbit hole of EDC bags and thank me later. If you guys haven't done so already, subscribe, hit that little bell. Like I said, I'm gonna list everything I can find for you down below. If you've made it all the way to the end of this video, leave me some type of tool, like a hammer or something like that, just because I feel like these are more like tools you keep in your purse, you know what I mean? Let me know, and when you do that, it just means the world to me, you guys. Watching my video all the way through really helps and benefits my channel. Lets me know that you appreciate these videos, and it honestly helps me to continue making them. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and until next time, I'm always your girl, Lorna Marie. Held in the echoes, secrets that we know, doors that open for us in a moment.